Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nurafika Nisa and I'm from bilingual class of public administration in Muhammadiyah University of Makassar. First of all, we give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing and mercies to give our life better. And salawat and salam be upon to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who saved the human life from destruction in the safety that the right path of Allah. In this change, I would like to review a book from Mr. Herbani Pasolong that is A Theory of Public Administration. This book is more emphasis on the theory of public administration because there are four the important reasons. The first one is the orientation shift of public administration that emphasis on state activity to be from and for public. The second is the development of history of public administration in various literature which always use state administration, not public administration. The third reason is academic development, which is based on not only on the combination of words administration and public, but the deeper understanding on public administration itself. The last reason is consideration that the discussion is more on public interest and not on the state. So, public administration is intended to be better understand the relation of government and public and increase the responsibility of the policy in various public needs. So, let's find out what is public administration has written by this book. Administration comes from two words, that is ad and minister. It means to serve or fulfill the needs. According to Sondang Pesiagian, administration is overall cooperation between two or more people based on rationality to achieve the goals. So administration is planned a job by a group of people to collaborate for achieve the goals based on efficient, effective, and rational. And public is general, people, society, folk, or citizen. According to Shafi'i, that say public is the people who have a good companionship through feelings, attitude, action that good and true based on the value on they have. So the writers make a conclusion that public administration is corporation, a group by a people for performing the government duty to fulfill the public needs. And then there are dimension of the element on public administration. The first one is the purpose is determined before carrying out a job. The second is cooperation between groups or institution. The third is the existence of facility used by a group or institution in carrying out the goals. And then, in this book, explain the paradigm of public administration. Among them, according to Denhardt, there are three paradigms, that is OPA or Old Public Administration, and NPM or New Public Management, and NPS or New Public Service. In this book, use the language that easy to understand. And after explaining the definition from another expert, this book has their own conclusion. So, as to give the understanding of public administration by this book. Unfortunately, some pages of this book are faded, but it's okay because it still can be read.